Hey, all you guys, aren't we so excited about this new Flex Plus? I know we're just all so excited. So, not having to plug it in, you've already saw Ashley over the moon. So, if you don't know me, I'm Judy Williams, and we're all on late because we're just so excited about this new Flex Plus. So, I got out my book and I was trying to decide what to make. And I was really enthralled about the emulsion blender. And I would also wanted to make something with the one avocado I have. So we're gonna start with the mayonnaise and see how we do and see how long it is, because I don't know how long I'm gonna last, but we'll try that. Okay, so this is what we're doing. We're going to make the mayonnaise. So, because I have never had an emulsion blender before at all, and I'm super pumped. Like I said, I have a Bosch blender, and a food processor, but I have never had one that does all of these things. I cannot believe that this does all of these things in one machine. So this is blowing my mind. Okay, so this is the recipe we're making. Easy homemade mayonnaise. So you know me, I have tons of allergies, right? So we're going to do, oh, the raw egg was not out of the fridge. Here we go, hang on. Raw egg. I thought I had everything ready, but apparently I did not have my egg out. Here is my egg. And I always try to break it in something. Let's see if we can do it this way. So I like that you have a container for everything. No shells. Good. I usually try to break it into a prep cup so that I don't end up with shells, but that went okay. I should watch my time. Okay, and then 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. And I was actually going to use our a new juicer to do the lemon, because we're gonna use it for the guac as well. So we only need 1 tablespoon for this one, but we need a whole half for the other one. You don't see my arm up. So who's on? Is anybody still up? Marie, you're still up. Who else? Danielle, hey Danielle. Look what's new in the kitchen. So this, I'm just so thrilled that I don't have to use the power cord for this. This is what's so exciting about this. This has a rechargeable battery, and it's got two rechargeable batteries. I'm using my left hand here. It's got two rechargeable batteries, and then you just sub them out and use this power bar, and then you put the battery clicks onto it. Just that simple. And then I'm going to connect that to what I'm using, which is going to be the immersion one originally. Hope I didn't leave that. Oh, yes, here. Snap this in like this. I got this. I should put it on the right way. There we go. And then I'm ready to go. That's how it works. No cords, no nothing. So very easy. So I'm gonna put that down there for a minute. I finished juicing my lemon. All right, awesome. This is very slick, by the way. This is our brand new juicer that came out in the spring. So 1 tablespoon. We're going to put that aside. If we make it to our next dip, we'll use that for that. And a teaspoon of Dijon. And see, so I've got, again, I've got allergies. So we're going to use dried mustard powder. And quarter teaspoon of salt. And 1 cup of vegetable oil. Okay, so it says to wait till the oil comes to the top. And then it says, so blend in low, keep the blender stationary until the mayonnaise begins to form, 30 seconds, and then slowly pull the blender up and side to side. Okay, so I'm gonna wait till it comes, so the oils come to the top. All right, so this has safety features on it. Always Pampered Chef has safety features. So the safety feature is, I believe, underneath. Okay. I hope this works okay, guys. If this gets me all messy, it won't be good. All right, so we put this in. Honey? My husband was with me last time when I turned this on. You can make it go faster or slower. When I use dry mustard, it's a bit thick. So honestly, I'm gonna add like a little bit of water. But can you see how it's working? I'm quite impressed here. I'm just gonna add like a touch of water, which I don't know if I'm supposed to, but I almost feel like it's a little bit thick. I don't know if it's too late to add water or not, but we're gonna do it anyways. Okay, so there's, like I say, a safety thing here. Let's turn it on again. This is phenomenal. I've never seen anything like this before. I've never made homemade mayonnaise. Maybe you guys have. I need a scraper. This is fabulous. Can you see how? I'm just gonna take this off, the battery pack off. And I'm gonna take the power bar off so that's not heavy anymore. So take the both of those are off. So I just have the immersion part here. I'm just gonna use my scraper, get all that yummy mayonnaise off. So it says now I can keep it for a week in the fridge because it's fresh. That is yummy. Cannot believe that. So then this comes with a lid. I'm sure if you want to transfer it into something else, you can. Definitely got to try this. So this just, well, that gets out of that really well with the scraper. I got to try it. Just gonna put this over here. But that is fabulous. And you know what? I literally have not eaten mayonnaise and I cannot tell you how long, because with my allergies, it's so hard to find because it usually has white vinegar in it. Look at that. How good this is. I'm sold. Love, love, love it. Okay, so that's our mayonnaise. Shall we move on to the, what I was gonna make next was going to be, how are we doing for time? Are you guys still wanna go on? How are we doing? I can't tell if we have any comments. Is that crazy? I know, right? Mayo back in my life. It's incredible. I can make potato salad. I can make coleslaw. I can make so many other things. I know, it looks delicious. I know, I can't get over it. Okay, so the next thing we were gonna make was something, okay, so green goddess dip. So this makes, so I will show you, I don't know how much Ashley showed you, but this is the part that has the blender part where you put the beaters in, right? And then you would attach the bar here, right? And then you'd put the battery on here, right? And you'd use your beaters here. And somebody is gonna show you that. So you're gonna see that one. But in case you're not here, I just wanted to show you that, how that's how that works. So then we're going to use the food processor, okay? So the food processor, I can't also get over how everything is ergonomically friendly. The handles, and again, I'm comparing to a Bosch, so it's not something that's cheap. So this lid comes off nicely, and it's very cushiony in here. It's got a nice rubber seal. And then it comes with two different blades like this. There's this one, and then there's a slicing one, very sharp. And I have my avocado here. And what I was gonna be doing is making this dip. So I'll put that over there. So, I hope you can see past this. My mayonnaise is just like blowing me away. Okay, so my avocado tool. I don't know if you've seen this, but this is our new avocado tool. And I'm hoping my avocado is not too ripe. I find with avocados, it's a very fine line. I don't know about you guys. I find avocados, you got a very fine time before it's, there we go. Okay, I'm gonna throw it at it and it's not gonna come out. There we go. That's how you get the seed out. There we go. And then you just take this, and I actually like to cut it myself, but it calls for two avocados in this dip, but I only have one. So and by the way, I'm just using the center blade for this recipe. So we are going to use, add ingredients to the processor and blend until smooth. Okay, one large avocado. So I'm just gonna scoop this into here. And again, maybe I should put this up here. Hopefully you can see okay. I only had one avocado, so we are just working with what we have. So we're just gonna do a half recipe. There you go, coming out of there nicely. I've just become, just more recently, a lover of avocados. Just realizing, I think, how good they are for you. Starting to incorporate them into more things. There we go. And we'll do this one. So how are you guys doing tonight? Are you getting in on those sales? I mean, and don't forget those, besides the electric, those blue cast iron enamels. If you are loving those cast iron enamels, get in on those while they're on sale or while they're available. I got sale on the brain. Make sure you get a hold of your consultant, whoever you invited, and find out what they've got going on before tonight. And if you're under me, like if you're somebody who likes to talk to me, you know that I'm going to be up till midnight tonight. So whatever questions you have, I'm here for you. Okay, so here we go. So avocado, 1 cup. Well, I use, this is my Greek yogurt in a measure all. And again, I'm using half of the recipe. So it called for sour cream and it called for Greek yogurt, but we're just gonna use, if it called for mayonnaise, I could put my mayonnaise in here, couldn't I? It called for Greek yogurt and we could definitely substitute the mayonnaise. But I don't have a Judy-friendly sour cream, so I just used yogurt. So, and then one lemon. So we got back our lemon here. So we're gonna use the rest of the lemon. And then calls for 4 sprigs of tarragon, and I have no idea how much 4 sprigs of tarragon is, so I'm gonna put some in my hand, the tarragon I have, and use that. That's kind of how I do things. I honestly don't know how much 4 sprigs is. I could have looked it up, but I didn't. And then 4 chives, 12 chives cut into thirds. I have green onions. So again, we're substituting, and I don't know how big chives are. Sometimes they're really big. So I kind of thought this might be the right size, but I don't know. You guys can correct me. I maybe cut them a bit small, but it's the first time with the blender live. So I wasn't really sure what it was gonna do yet. I know it's gonna be great, but 1/2 teaspoon of salt and some pepper. So this is my 1/2 teaspoon. So, all right, so I am very excited to see what this does. All right, my lid is back here. Now this has also a chute. So if you're gonna be using it for processing, you just push things down here. And it's got this to push things down. And again, it's got things here you can just see easily where you attach it and where it closes, and it just snaps in. So again, if I'm doing this in steps, I put my power bar on. And it just snaps in, you can't do it wrong. And then you put your battery on. And when I unboxed this, I hadn't read any instructions and I quickly figured it out. So you guys will figure it out too, believe me. And again, there's always a safety feature that you have to release something before you can make it work. So if you have a little kid, don't worry that your small child is gonna pick it up and walk away with it and do something to their kid and brother with it, because they can't. There's always a safety feature that they're not going to notice. They're not going to notice that there's something they have to push at the same time. They won't be able to figure it out. So that always makes me feel good, because I have grandchildren, and I'm sure all of you with small children, it makes you feel good too. You know, you don't want them doing something with the dog, with the blender, right? Okay, so the safety feature here is where? So this is where I'm going to be pushing, but I believe it is, where is it now? It is, oh, it's underneath here. Okay, so see where it is? So the safety feature is underneath at the back here, and then I can release it here. For a minute, can you not even get over that? Like, that is intense. Let's just look at it. You can also speed it up and slow it down. That was just the medium speed. That was not even like as fast as it goes. Look at it. That is crazy. That is not as fast as it goes. So when you get it on that medium speed, you then can push plus or minus, because I already tried this with nothing in it before when I was unboxing, and you can make it go fast or slow. That was just medium. Wasn't that like That is so crazy. It just demolished everything. At first I thought it's like that funny sound. I'm like, and it was just getting going. And then it just demolished it. Okay, I'm just gonna put this on, take off the battery, take off the power bar, and take off the lid. I'm just gonna, oops, that fell out. So I'm just gonna check it for like how it, wait, what's the consistency? Do I need to, no, I don't think you want it. I don't think you want it really, really thin. Oh my goodness, that's delicious. That is so good. I don't even know what you do with this. Okay. Bright dip tastes great with chips, veggies, or toast on sandwich bread. Now, maybe they have it a bit thinner, but I like a bit of consistency with mine, but I could process it more. Should I process it some more, do you think? Okay, let's try some more. Okay, we'll put this back on. Put this back on. And this back on. Okay, this is a good time to tell you guys that if you sign up as consultants, this is a brand new product. You automatically get it at half price, right? This is what we get as consultants. And I got this as brand new, absolutely for free. I earned it for free in our free-for-all, in our fall free-for-all. So this is what, these are the perks you get as consultants. So there's nothing better than being a consultant. So if you guys are interested at all about learning what we do, like we're pampered but not perfect, as you can tell, and we have a lot of fun. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, so I'm gonna take the safety off and I'm gonna actually show you, this is where the safety is back here. Okay, and then I'm gonna push it at the front again. And I'm gonna speed it up this time. Love it. That's very thin now. You could like do it again faster, or you can like slow it down. Okay, I'm gonna take the battery pack off first, and then I'm gonna take the power bar off, and then taking the, oops, gonna take the lid off. I just see, oh yeah, it's really creamy now. I'll just show you. If I take out the center part. Very good. That's impressive to me that you can do it so well. But I sound like I'm harping on this, but I really like the safety features. That's really well thought out, and they're not right beside. So you, again, have to have a big enough hand or use two hands and have that dexterity and that thought process to figure out the safety feature. It's not going to be incidental that you just pick it up and accidentally fall on the safety feature and be able to do it. So you're not going to be worried that your, you know, five-year-old is going to pick it up and do it. It's not going to be that simple. You'd need direction. That looked delicious. It tastes delicious. It's a great recipe. That's awesome. All right, you guys. I hope you like that. that's just a couple of the features. So that was the immersion blender, and that was just using the main attachment that was called the multi-use blade. And that we made that great dip. So I hope you guys stay tuned, because we are going to have so many more new products to show you guys tomorrow, and more about the Flex Plus is coming as well. We're going to show you many more features of it. And so I hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you guys all have a great night. So thanks for tuning in. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye guys.